Hello guys, from this video and the other videos, I'll be starting a new tutorial on MySQL database. In other words, we'll be doing database programming. And over here, you can see I'm using XAMPP. I've already installed it. Go ahead and go to Google and download XAMPP. XAMPP, which means go ahead and download XAMPP. Once you download something, you are good to go. You can download Workbench, MySQL Workbench, or WAMP server. Over here, you can see I'm using XAMPP. XAMPP, which means cross-platform application, which is the X means cross-platform, and the A means Apache, the M means MySQL, the P means PHP and Perl. Click here to start your server, and also click on this to start MySQL so we can start programming. And it takes us to PHP MyAdmin interface. It takes a little time to load PHP MyAdmin. So if you got this interface, then you are good to go to follow on the tutorial. So over here, we are going to create database, and nearly typically the basic things you need to know about MySQL or database programming. If you can use XAMPP, WAMP, over here we're using XAMPP, and you can use WAMP or MySQL Workbench. If you get this to you, you're good to go. You can follow along. So we go on to MySQL SQL. That is where we write our SQL codes. So in this phase, we will learn how to create databases and tables. So they get on it. Start by saying create database. Then you give your database a name. Give your database a name. So let's call ours. And your database name can be nearly everything. Let's call ours text. Let's call it test 1, then you terminate. Now, if you're creating a database, you just need to type this keyword called create function. And on this, this create function, you say, okay, you want to create something. What is it? It's a database. As you can see, it is pretty neat. Okay, then give your database a name. So this is the syntax. Then once you give your database a name, you need to end the line with a semicolon. Over here, you can decide not to end it. But if you have another line under this, if there is another line under this line, then you need to end it with a semicolon. Once you're done with that, then you hit on go. Okay, and you can see MySQL return an empty result set that is 0 rows, query took 0.14 seconds. Now you can see over here our test one database has been created. So now if you want to create tables inside this database, then you need to select the database by clicking on it. So now we are now in the database. So inside our database, what do we want to do? You want to create tables. Every database needs tables. And over here you can see it is written the create tables. You can give the table name. You can use the system, my PHP MyAdmin interface to create tables and even the database itself very easily. But as students, you need to know the SQL language itself. So we won't be doing that. We'll be creating it. We'll be creating it by using our SQL code. By using our SQL code. So hover on to SQL and create a table. So we can type say create. Then you want to create table. So you type create table. Then you give your table a name. So let's say your table name can be anything. We can also call it text 1, 2. Now we've created the table, but without columns. So we need to create our columns, or rather we need to provide our columns. So first column I recommend you should always do is provide your ID. And that is, let's say, you can say test ID, and it will be better for underscore. So it takes the variable as integer. Then with integer, we can decide to give it a size or not to give it a size. That depends on you. And now this variable int means this test ID here will only take variable, will only take integers, which is numbers. In other words, it's not going to take decimal numbers or alphabet or any symbol, only integers, which is numbers. So let me say auto increment, because that is going to be our primary key. We will talk about primary key later on, but primary keys, they are unique identifiers. That helps you to identify any data on each one. So when we say auto increment, means anytime you enter, when we say auto increment, which means anytime we enter data, let's say we enter data one, the second one, the primary key should automatically, this test ID should automatically update itself to 2. I hope you get the idea. So it should automatically update itself to 2. So you say auto increment. Then you say not no, which means it should not be empty. It should never be empty. There should always be a value. Then we end the line here by a comma. Then we say, let's say we are creating this, let me say our next column is, let's say student's name. And student name, what variable do you want to give? Let's say voucher. And you give it a size. How many characters do you want them to enter? How many characters? So let's say 150. Then we end it with another comma. We say age and we give it integer. There's nobody's age with decimal or alphabet. They are always numbers. So we give age as an integer. We add that. Then say the date underscore added, and we give it the variable of date and time. Now this is our last line. With the last line we add no comma or we add no comma. But you can decide when we add no semicolon. So now, as you notice, I talk about primary key, but in this here we are not having the primary key, so we bring primary key. Every database table, every table must have a primary key. Now, our primary key will be set to new. And then we can see we are having an error because we didn't terminate this one. We didn't end the line there. And you can see the error is gone. So we will say test underscore ID. So we see this is our primary key. And now I think we are good to go. Sorry, I deleted. Okay. And now when you are done, you hit on go. Let me walk you guys through one last time. Let me copy this and hit on go. You can see our table is created successfully inside our database. Now let me walk you guys through one last time. Now anytime you want to create a table, you start with the word create. Then what do you want to create? A table with the keyword table. Then the next thing should be the name of your table. Now when you are done with your name of the table, you open two parentheses. Inside the parentheses, you provide your table columns. So here we can bring this one here. To still work for you, you can see we can no errors because this comma here means it is an end of a line. So now our first column is test underscore ID, and each variable is an integer. And over here we see auto increment. Auto increment over here means it should automatically update itself anytime we insert a data. Then we see not null, which means it should not be empty. Then our next column, you see our student name, and we say, oh, it's voucher. Now this voucher here, it accepts anything. Remember, there are other people's names with hyphen in it. So if you use test or char, you will get your system will crash when somebody enters a name with hyphen or a slash in it. So anytime you should know the kind of variables you're going to choose for your columns. And voucher, integer, date, text, and char, and blob are the most common ones. So voucher, it merely accepts anything. It accepts alphabet, integers, and even symbols. With the age, we see it int. And this primary key here is one of the most important things. Every table needs a primary key. Don't forget that. And this primary key here, primary keys are unique identifiers, which allows you to identify a specific data in the table. So every table needs a primary key. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, comment, and like. See you in the next tutorial. In the next tutorial, we are going to, now that we've created our database and table successfully, we are going to learn how to insert data into our table. See you in the next tutorial.